Steam Deck is an awesome device.
Obviously, it's great for gaming, but because it's just a normal computer under the hood, I've been using it increasingly as just a handheld PC. It's great for web browsing, and since I installed Bazite, even some more complex tasks. And since mine is a Steam Deck OLED, the screen looks great for YouTube or any content, really. But it's lacking a feature that most people just take for granted these days. Since you saw the title and thumbnail, you know that's a camera. And I actually recorded all of the A-roll for this segment with it. And I gotta say, this isn't your average laptop webcam. This thing will even comfortably go up to 4K. The only reason I recorded that segment in 1080p is because that's the resolution of the monitor on my editing computer. This thing is seriously impressive, and you can build one too. Now, the idea of integrating a webcam with the Steam Deck isn't a new idea. I thought of it originally a few months ago, only to Google search it and find these two Reddit threads of people who've already done it. The first one is by user Chen Jin Ming. Now, this one looks awesome, it's super polished. However, the OP never showed any specs, or tutorials, or instructions, or any information at all, so that's great. This second guide is by OpenBag2, and it has a lot more detail, and also is in essentials what I'm going to be doing today, taking a regular USB webcam and giving it a USB-C port. However, I also had another design criteria. I want a camera that swivels. You know, like this Chromebook my school used to have, or like that Samsung phone from that one time, or the PSP, I think. I think it would be really cool to have both a front-facing and rear-facing camera, so here we go. Now, when I started this project, I actually wanted to use the camera from a framework laptop, since it claims to be USB from the pinout and was the right form factor. However, this absolutely sucked. I connected it using a ribbon cable to this breakout board, but it just wouldn't work no matter what I tried. One extra level of complexity was having to use a level shifter, since USB uses 5 volts and the framework camera uses 3.3. This is where I was sure there was a fault, but because the whole thing showed zero signs of life, it was difficult to troubleshoot. I tried using different level shifters, I ended up with this monstrosity somehow. Clearly, some people have got it working, but no one's posted any public resources for idiots like me to use. But anyways, attempt one left a $30 hole in my pocket for not even a paperweight. This camera's too light to hold any paper. It's literally useless, except as a taunting reminder of my failure. So anyways, I bought this camera from Amazon.
Hello.
And indeed, it works perfectly with my Steam Deck. So great. Now, I also needed a USB-C plug. I have this one from the previous attempt, so let's just harvest that. Now, the reason I chose this Adafruit plug is firstly because they aren't evil, like Amazon, but also because USB-C is particularly picky about whether something is a host or a sub-device. Basically, a sub-device is like a peripheral, in this case, our camera. And a host is whatever you're plugging that peripheral into, like a computer, or in this case, our Steam Deck. USB-C ports need a certain configuration of resistors to properly pick up as one or the other, otherwise they won't work. However, for some reason, the overwhelming majority of Amazon listings for USB-C ports are configured for hosts, not sub-devices like our camera. But our Adafruit one is configured for sub-devices out of the box, so I decided to save myself the hassle of micro-soldering and just bought that one. I'll talk about this more later, but first, we should talk about some of the other parts. Now, one of the reasons I bought this camera is because the cable detaches with this little JST connector. After a little research, I determined that this connector is a JST-SH connector, and ordered cables that matched. This will greatly simplify assembly, and it means I don't have to sacrifice this perfectly good USB cable. Although, one quirk, USB uses 4 pins to carry power and data, but for some reason this camera has 5 pins? I tested this with a multimeter, and our mysterious bonus pin is just tied to ground. Why do we need an extra ground pin? I don't know, we have one right here. Maybe it's just a separate pin for the shielding or something, but I'm kinda stumped.
It's fine though, we'll just solder both of those wires to ground on the USB-C port. Finally, I ordered these magnetic USB-C connectors, which should allow our camera to swivel like I wanted, as well as this M2 screw set to attach everything together. Anyways, now we need to assemble everything, so that means soldering the USB-C port to our connector. Okay, so it is time to solder up our camera. I've already roughly parted the wires based on how they're assembled in this cable here. And basically, we will just attach those wires to this little USB-C guy. It is hot out here, so I'm gonna get started on that. Okay, all soldered up, it's time to test. And it is not working. Yeah, it turns out I just got the data positive and negative lines backwards. It's fine, we can just swap them. And once I did that, it worked. But you have to remember, this is the voice of a man who just spent literal days troubleshooting the framework camera.
Well, that's just great, isn't it?
It was not a fun experience, we'll put it like that.
Don't you just love technology?
Okay, now electronically everything is done, but we don't want to just leave our camera looking like this. So it's time to do some 3D modeling. Now today, our CAD software of choice is Tinkercad, because I can't be bothered to learn anything else. Either way, with this new sketch tool, I honestly don't really need anything more powerful. This is a pretty simple project in theory, so we should be fine.
Attempt 1.
Okay, I don't even know what happened here. Let's just move on.
Attempt 2.
Alright, so I actually found a proper model of my camera online, which saves me the trouble of painstakingly taking like 100 tiny little measurements. I don't even have a caliper, I just had to eyeball stuff with a ruler, which is great and not frustrating at all. The model I found came from some website named GrabCAD, and I will tell you, it sucks! You have to make an account, which includes a bunch of personal data like your profession and IRL phone number. I just put fake info in. I am not giving a random website any information about me. Oh, and also don't forget that the account creation process is entirely broken on Firefox, which wasted a bunch of my time trying to figure out what was going wrong.
Attempts 3 and 4.
Revisions 3 and 4 were pretty uneventful. I mostly just shrunk the casing down. However, there were still a few issues. It was just a little bit too big to sit flush on top, especially with a case. And if you held the Steam Deck in pretty much any comfortable position, the camera would slide down because it's too heavy for the magnet in the USB-C swivel. So that's a little unfortunate, but we'll think of something.
Attempt 5.
Now, this revision is supposedly the thinnest possible design, and if you use your Steam Deck without a case, it lays almost exactly flush. However, I do have a case on my Steam Deck, so this is not gonna work. Having the camera be flush could also potentially impact cooling, since it completely covers the vent. What I do know is that this will definitely be a problem, and we need to make this design thinner. But how? The thickest part of our design is our Adafruit USB-C board, and while we could probably trim it, I A, have no idea how to do that, and B, would rather not inhale fiberglass. And from that point on, I had an idea. An idea that I hated but couldn't get out of my brain. I had to go back to Amazon.
Ready for setup.
Okay, so remember when I was talking about how I didn't want to buy USB-C ports from Amazon? Yeah, this was a lot of annoying research, especially because in some listings, each of the photos showed different plugs. I eventually bought two sets, figuring that if the first one didn't work out, I could just use the second and the others could be spare parts. Luckily, after soldering the new connector, everything worked perfectly, and I could keep revising my design. If you are looking to buy some yourself, in general, you'll want to look for ports that advertise OTG support or have a 5.1K resistor. Bonus points if you can get both. I only used the port that worked on the first try, so I'll link that one in the description. Anyways, here's the final design.
Attempt 7.
dang, I think it looks pretty good. In this final revision, there's a small cutout for the Steam Deck's cooling vent, as well as making the screws flush with the casing. And to stop the camera from sliding around like earlier, I add some Velcro on each side for it to stick to. What, if it's good enough for the astronauts, it's good enough for me. One thing to note, there was a little hiccup at the end. Remember that opening shot that I recorded with this camera? Well, I was originally gonna plug it into my PC and record it from my desk. I tested this by plugging it into a cable with this crummy USB-C adapter, and then all of a sudden it didn't work anymore on my Steam Deck, or my phone where it had worked previously. But anytime I plugged it back into the PC, it worked again. I'm sorry, what? This is the strangest issue I've ever encountered in any of my projects. I have no idea what happened or how, but I woke up the next morning, I reassembled some stuff, and now it works on my phone. Okay, so I tried it on my Steam Deck, and it still didn't work. Wait, now it does work. Literally 2 seconds ago, it wasn't being picked up. Whatever, dude, I'm done. Anyways, that's the whole project. Technical difficulties aside, it was actually a lot of fun and I learned a lot from the process, which is really the goal with these sorts of things. Over the next few days, I'm gonna post my 3D models and maybe write up some documentation as well if you wanna try this yourself. All in all, this is a pretty simple project. The most difficult part is just soldering the USB-C port onto those wires. So I hope that this is somewhat useful for someone. Anyways, thanks for watching. I think I'm gonna take a nap. Hey, wait, don't leave yet. You may have noticed some new music in my videos, including this sick outro beat. They were composed by my friend Adrien, who lets me use his music in my videos. They genuinely sound great, so thanks, Adrien. You're an awesome dude. His channel will be in the description. Anyways, have a nice day.